I don't mean to hurt them. I can't control it. I think I need help, but other times I think I can solve it. And for the record, doctor, this chose me, I never chose it. It's so easy to say, oh, it's all in your head, don't lose focus. But what happens when the pressure's near and the problems pile? And you wake up somewhere and the noise in the room is a different dial. I guess my pain has moved up a file.
It's all good. The doctors will be here any sec.
So, am I going down for murder?
They wouldn't tell me anything in the station.
Of course they wouldn't. The real killer planted that bottle in my jacket to put me in the frame. But I'm going to prison.
Then we'll work out who had access to your jacket yesterday.
What, the same jacket that was sat on the back of a chair in a busy pub for hours? Yeah, great idea.
Then we'll plant some drugs on Yates, get him suspended.
No! Can you even hear yourself?
I'm going to fire off some emails to my forensic contacts. We might get the results before the police do.
There's no point. Whoever did it for a reason. It must have been the same tranquilizer that killed Mac.
You're right. There's no alternative. You need to leave the country.
So, how are you feeling?
Good.
And how's your new mate?
She's really friendly.
Don't. You'll make me blush.
The blood nurse Jill took will just run the usual tests, and I've asked Dr. Mallet to join us because she's counselled you in the past.
Lily, I was so sorry to hear you'd hurt yourself again, but we can help. In our sessions here, we'll draw up a safety plan, and you'll learn from fellow patients like Imogen how they stop themselves self-harming. Does that sound useful?
Yeah.
It is okay to admit there's a part of you that doesn't want to stop.
There isn't.
I'll be here. So will Dr. Keeley. So will the whole team to help you get better. You did the right thing, choosing to come in. It's only the start, but it's a good start.
Yaz, don't bank me. It's about Lily. She's in the mental health unit. She's been self-harming again.
What? Why didn't she come to us? We could have helped her.
Maybe it's because we've been fighting with each other. Apparently she didn't go to her family either. That's what Tony said. Listen, Yaz. I am really sorry about Steve. All the hassle with your mum and Imran.
Well, that doesn't matter right now, does it? We have to think of Lily.
Do you think we should go and see her?
I need to ring the hospital first. I'll text Prince too.
No, because then we'll have to text Romeo and everyone will end up finding out that Lily's in hospital.
Lily's where? Oh, stay out of this, Juliet.
Yeah, I will, as long as you keep Romeo out of it too. He's got enough stressing him out at the minute. This is going to tip him over the edge.
Whatever, your call. Come on.
Hey, that Goldie's got a gob on her, all right. She won't stop texting, and now she's sending us voice memos. I know my flair for drag is almost as good as me clowning skills, and that's saying something, but I wish she'd just leave us alone for one piddling little. All right, who's died? Tell me no one's died.
Nobody died, but you need to sit down. It's Lily. She's been admitted to a mental health ward.
She's been self-harming again.
Plus, she had a panic attack. Scott, I've never seen her in such a bad way.
Well, why didn't you tell us?
Oh. You thought it would send me into some sort of relapse. Well, we haven't told Sinead either.
We didn't want her to stay up here on Laurie's trip, unless we absolutely have to.
I mean, I know she's been stressed, what with a uni project and exams and all that Prince and Romeo stuff, but I should have done more. I mean, of all people, I should have done more.
No, Scott, right, this is no one's fault. You know Lily is a past master to keeping secrets.
Yeah, I mean, if she told us how she was feeling, we could have supported her, but she didn't.
We can now. And we're going to go and visit her and tell her that we're going to help her get better and support her through all of this.
You reckon you can come?
Yeah. If she needs me there, then that's where I'll be.
Oh, okay.
So, are we gonna do another drag night tonight? Rub Gracie's nose right in it.
I think Mercedes had a point. That stupid bar was a well stupid.
But that shouldn't stop Scott dragging up. I mean, he said he can finally do me.
Right, I'm gonna go up at the workshop.
See you in a bit then.
Oh, Lily's in hospital. She's hurting herself again.
What? Poor girl.
My poor son. She has broken his heart over 100 times. Why is she texting you for, anyway?
She didn't. Yas did. You think I should go? Be with her?
You promised Diane that you wouldn't see Lily, for her sake and for yours.
Yeah, but she's all on her own.
Oh, except for Tony, Diane, Scott, and a hospital full of doctors and nurses.
Yeah, plus Silver needs you up at workshop, so come on. Chop, chop.
What?
Yeah, something about a woodwork emergency.
What even is a woodwork emergency?
Well, I don't know. I'm not a carpenter. All he said is that he needs a big lad to help him out. Look, you look after your family, yeah? Let the professionals look after Lily.
I'm going to try and remember all the stuff he says in there.
Well, hopefully the tools we talked about will really help. It will all become second nature before too long.
Thank you.
No worries, Lily.
Sir? How was your first session?
It was good. Really good.
Breaking news. The doctors here know the stuff.
Does that light always make that noise?
Turn it off if you want. But I reckon it'd be a bit grim trying to live in the dark. You got any books to read or...?
My auntie will bring some.
You can borrow one while you're waiting. Keeps your mind on other things.
My mum loved this book, and I love it too. Thank you.
Got a room for two little ones?
Of course, come in. I thought you two were blanking each other.
There was no way we were missing seeing you.
Lily, I thought you'd stopped all this. I have to get him a Romeo.
I couldn't. Why not? Lily, I know you got issues, but hurting yourself, it only makes things worse.
It makes everyone go quiet. Just for a moment.
But it's only for a moment. And you've got to do it again and again, and you end up in it. It doesn't work.
I know. But doing me EPQ, trying to get the grades for uni, then the aggro with Prince and Romeo. All I can think about is finding a way out to this village, and when the stress gets too much...
You can talk to me. Or Yas.
Romeo's the only one who understands. The pressure, the dark thoughts.
We all have dark thoughts too. Like if I really played up to my heart problems, could I get a free trip to Disneyland? Or would anyone even notice if I pushed Imran down a well?
Lily, you're not alone. So why don't you give us a chance to help you? Romeo's no good.
Neither am I. Didn't you hear about the presentation? You're getting to med school anyway.
She's right. With the right help from the experts, especially my super smart sister, you were never ever going to hurt yourself again.
Get the train to Holyhead and then the ferry to Dublin.
And come back when the fuss has died down.
You'll be wanted for murder. You can't ever come back.
Well, then I can't leave in the first place.
You have to.
Well, I'll never see you again.
So be it.
Easy for you to say.
No, it's not. You become a part of my life. Losing you will be the opposite of easy.
Well, then let's fight this thing.
It'll never work. It was never going to. They've already won. You'll be denied bail. It could be months before we go to trial. I know what prison is like, Romeo. It almost destroyed me. I won't let it destroy you too. I promise you I'll look after Juliet. This has to be goodbye. I love you, son. meeting you, getting to know you, trying to be some kind of father to you. It's made me a man. Now you have to be a man and run. Run now.